picture to the left, you can see them little black things. Those are the bacteria in the root tip, the hair tip. So you could imagine that. Those microbes there in the tip secreting ethylene that's causing that hair to continue to grow. Turns out nitrogen fixation appears to depend on this process in some plants. And if you stop the movement or you disturb plants, then nitrogen fixation stops. So this is one of these root hairs, and you can see these arrows are showing clusters of bacteria, because when the plant is doing this in their hair, it's knocking these, jostling these bacteria around, and it's replicating them, cloning them. That because the bacteria are around the sides of the cell, right? So what's happening is the water pressure inside the plant cell causes the hair to expand, and that causes the bacteria around the sides, around the outsides of it, right, to be squeezed up.
Will beneficial bacteria really increase your root hair growth? Well, in this video, we're going to get into it with James White and the rest of the team here on Perfect Gardens TV. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. And if you haven't checked us out on Instagram and Facebook or our $2.99 membership, where there's over 115 growers ready and willing to assist you through your growing practices, well, I highly recommend to do so. Let's go ahead and get into the video.
Make sure to hit the join button on the bottom of every video.
Why is root hair growth specifically associated with bacteria there, or maybe even be fungi in some cases, because they also are producing ethylene. Ethylene is the key. And this is another one of my graduate students, Ivy Chang, and she did some work that shows, you know, you put the bacteria, you remove all the bacteria. This is a root over here to the left. There's no hairs. Put the bacteria on and you see their hairs. And if you look at the tips of these little hairs, little heads there, those are bacteria that are coming out of those cells. And why? It turns out that the microbes are producing ethylene. That's the theory. Ethylene, and we have experimental evidence that suggests that. We also know that the microbes are producing nitric oxide, or nitric oxide is being formed. And both of those, nitric oxide and ethylene, are hormones for the plant, and it will cause cell growth. But anyway, we have this, and those microbes accumulate. The picture to the left, you can see them, little black things. Those are the bacteria in the root tip, the hair tip. So you could imagine that. Those microbes there in the tip secreting ethylene that's causing that hair to continue to grow, to elongate. So, and here's one of the plants from Bonaire. Again, that was a nice trip, getting multiple species studies happening there. But this is a sedge, and they grow without, they grow basically without soil, and just in these little rock areas. If you look at the root hair below, this is the sedge root hair, and you can see the red areas, those are the bacteria, and they're in that periplasmic space. But look to the bottom.
Wow, look at them travel. Look at them travel. That's amazing. How fast is this sped up? Is this
just slightly. This is about 11. Let's see, these move at about 11 micrometers per second.
So they're so going fast.
Yeah. So this is what happens. This is what you see in a living root hair, right? But if you pull that plant out of the soil, this stops. Pull it out of the soil, put it on a slide and look at it, and you don't see this.
Wow.
So this is how plants in root hairs manage these microbes. This
how
is how
fast do they come back? I think about transplanting now. How fast do they come back?
It would just be probably a day or two, something like that. There's actually articles about this, specifically nitrogen fixation. Turns out nitrogen fixation appears to depend on this process in some plants. And if you stop the movement or you disturb plants, then nitrogen fixation stops. And we think it stops because in order to fix nitrogen, the plants have to be doing cyclosis in their tissues.
Do they stop because of the light, or do they stop because they're taken out of the soil?
Because they stop. If you pull the root out, what happens is you move the root hairs and you break what's called the cytoskeleton, right? The cytoskeleton, the cell skeleton. The cytoskeleton is this internal skeleton in these cells that's made of microtubules and microfilaments. And these are little protein structures, right? And if you move the hair, it breaks, and then the cell can't move. It can't move. It can't do cyclosis. So it takes hours or days, depending on the conditions, for that cytoskeleton to get rebuilt. And then you get this movement again. Okay, so that's the short answer. The long answer, I guess.
No, thank you. That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah.
No, it's cool. We don't think of plants as doing this, but plants are very active. And even a root hair is not just this little thing that's just sitting there absorbing nitrogen from the soil and other nutrients. It's active like this.
It's a very complex machine, man. God, look at all these processes.
It is a machine. There's a mechanism for it. A plant, I mean, and you said it, Dave, a plant is a microprocessing machine. Yeah. It's a microprocessing machine. Animals are not. You think of animals, we get the microbes into our gut. We don't put them all over our bodies. I mean, they are on our skin and so forth, but we try to limit them in our guts. They don't go in our cells like this.
Right. We always give Henry Ford the credit for, you know, popularizing the industrial age and assembly line. But geez, man, these plants,
they do it. They really are a machine here for doing it. And it's really just really cool.
Microprocessor, like Dave said, computers. Again, it was just like, oh, wow. Wow.
So this is one of these root hairs. And you can see these arrows are showing clusters of bacteria. Because when the plant is doing this in their hair, it's knocking these, jostling these bacteria around, and it's replicating them, cloning them, right? And so you can see probably this cluster here that to the lower arrow probably came from a single bacterium that the plant replicated and made a bunch of. And so now it's cloning these bacteria that work with it, and it's going to put them back out into the soil. It's cloning them, the good ones, right? The bad ones are fully degraded. They're not that useful probably, but these are the ones that work with it pretty well and that go inside and survive, and there's the nutrient transfer. Right?
So when cells regenerate, you're telling me they're also regenerating the bacteria that's in them as well?
They are.
Wow. Oh my God. That's amazing.
Bacteria. They're cultivating, they're ranching, they're farming, however you want to put it. But they're growing cells typically will have some of these bacteria in it.
They really are farming cells. They are cloning.
They are.
They are cloning the bacteria. They are actually generating the bacteria. That is amazing. They're not just taking it up in the soil. They are creating it.
They are causing them to replicate inside, and they're replicating them. Yeah.
Wow.
No, it's absolutely right. They are farming these microbes. This is actually, look at this. This shows a root hair.
If we can get them to farm Bitcoin, holy crap. No, I'm just kidding. Let's keep going. I'm sorry.
You see the tip? You see the little clouds in the tip of this? Can you see that? The little.
Yeah, they're accumulating a lot. You're accumulating
in the tip. Okay, so that's what they do. They accumulate in this tip. And then that's from there where they secrete ethylene, and then they will cause that hair to elongate. And when they do that, they eject the microbes. This actually shows one of these, and you can see it's filled with microbes. It's fat with microbes, with bacteria. Some of these are red, some of them are clear, but there's still lots of microbes. Only the ones that touch the membrane are going to be stained red like this, because that's where they get exposed to the superoxide and so forth. But the others that aren't touching the membrane are, we don't see them stained here, but they're filled. This hair actually was the actual membrane, the little cell of the hair is a little needle shaped thing inside this big club shaped root hair, right? So the cell itself, the plant cell itself is little. And all of this stuff out here, these are microbes in these hairs. And they're coming out. And you can see here to the left with arrows, these are all bacteria that have been ejected out. So they're pumping up, they're making a lot of these microbes, and they're pumping them out the tips of those hairs. And so those are going back to the soil in more massive numbers. So the plant is really engineering this rhizosphere environment, these populations in the rhizosphere, putting out more of these microbes that it likes and it uses, right?
they always say if you want a large root system, you want phosphorus. But no, if you want a large root system, you need a large bacteria system.
You do.
It's just, wow. And the root tip and all the pictures you're showing, there's always kind of like a little, bulb where it's bigger. Is that because of the, after seeing that video, is that because of the accumulation and then it's with the ethylene, then it's causing it to then eventually stretch that part out. And there's always going to be a part that's more, it's bigger where the accumulation's happening, or like even in that picture, you can kind of see, you know, there's a slight difference. It's not that part of the shadow, like it gets bigger.
I will tell you, you guys are very perceptive in seeing stuff. It's actually part of the mechanism. And what happens is these tips, these hair tips, have thin walls, like the thin walls on the meristem, on the root tip meristem, right? So on these hair tips, there are thin walls, and it's like a plastic, like an elastic, right? And so what happens here, because these tips are thin, the bacteria, I guess I can show it better in this next image. Okay, so showing here, what happens, you can see this diagram, you can see this red is the cluster. This is where ethylene gets secreted. It causes an expansion in the growth. And when that grows, then it pushes out these microbes out of little breaks, little pores that form in this tip. Well, as it turns out, okay, so then you see the beginning here, these little blue dots down to see here, these are the microbes again. This is without all the microbes in the tip. Okay, so then it builds up these again. And what happens is, because this wall is thin and elastic, rather than these microbes, rather than being constantly rotated around, they will go out here in this little soft pocket at the tip, right, where the wall is like elastic. And they'll get stuck out there in that little pocket. And they'll just keep, as the plant builds them up, they'll just keep accumulating out there until there's a bunch. And then when there's a bunch there, they'll produce enough ethylene to then cause that growth spurt again. And you'll have that growth spurt and they'll be squirted out again.
It's like an internal like pressure relief valve. And then the system kind of restarts itself.
Yeah, I was thinking the same exact thing.
Exactly. It has an accumulation and there's a pressure difference and it contracts and the cycle starts again, or almost like that's how I'm visualizing it in my head right now.
It is. And we're very much, you know, in a modern era, you know, I'm just like you guys, you know, it's a machine, a little machine, and we can view that, you know, almost like the mechanics of it, you know, and looking at the mechanism of the system, you know, very much reductionist modern view of things. You know? I mean, we don't see it as magic, you know, unfortunately, we don't see it as magic, but, you know, it's really a cool system that plants have developed. This actually is a tomato root hairs, and you can see the bacteria coming out. You can see how
look how it shuts it to the end. Wow.
Yeah, you can see it number three. Look at number three there, and you can actually see those three little holes. It's like three little holes as it does it again.
It's like pooping.
At the tip. It is like,
Sorry.
And this happens repeatedly like that. Every time there's a growth spurt, right, you have this kind of ejection. And this is, you know, I mean, this happens. There's other cellular processes that are involved here. For example, potassium is probably involved because these hairs have a vacuole in there, and the swelling is probably happening because the plant cell is putting, in order to make the growth, is putting potassium into that vacuole in the center of that hair, and that causes water to rush in, and then that causes this whole swelling to kind of go to the end as water rushes in and causes the bacteria to be ejected. So, I mean, it's all kind of the plant physiology, the kind of mechanisms of plant physiology that are involved.
So when we look at number two, and as you can see, there's like a void as it's pushing it up. Is that water pressure or that's
That's water pressure, that because the bacteria are around the sides of the cell, right? So what's happening is the water pressure inside the plant cell causes the hair to expand, and that causes the bacteria around the sides, around the outsides of it, right, to be squeezed up. And as they're squeezed up, some of them come out the tip. You see how that works?
I love that. I love that. It's
yeah.
Wow.
It's crazy. You got to admit, it's crazy stuff. This is crazy
stuff. Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Especially how they use the water. You know, water goes up the tree. It goes out the roots. It goes in the leaves. That's amazing. I'm sorry. It's just little things like that.
It is. It is. I mean, the whole plants are fantastic living microprocessing machines.
And then the other question beyond that was, what minerals have you found to be to identify to be the best IPM for natural, like best, like making sure to have those right trace minerals?